Hi, and welcome to the 3D Printing Bunker with BeardedTinker. Today, we'll once again visit bed adhesion tests, but this time with my new PEI textured spring steel bed. We'll start in a couple of seconds. As the title says, this was the third time I'm testing bed print adhesion, but this one I'm testing on my brand new PEI textured spring steel sheet bed. This is something I received a week, two or three ago. I can't remember exactly. Video on unboxing on mail day is still not out. I presume it will be out in a couple of days. But let's go over the printing differences. First of all, what I forgot to do, I forgot to, on some of my prints, first print or second print, I think, I forgot to remove brim for the print, and it was really hard to remove this one layer high print from the bed, because it really does stick very well on the print. I'll show you with this stripe, I left it here for the nozzle cleaning or nozzle priming, however you want to call it. I really love this PEI textured spring steel sheet bed. This one just popped up right now when I touched the build plate, because it did cool down and all those plates are very flexible, and I didn't even flex it a lot. I'd probably just flex it like this and it just popped up. So let's look at the underside. First thing what you have to notice is something that I never managed to do with the PEI sticker spring steel sheet bed or with your original one, is that all those corners, and this is 210 millimeter wide print, all those corners really kept stuck on the bed and didn't move a bit. So there is no end warping here on any of the corners, and this is something that, as I said, I never managed to do with any other build plate. But what I notice here is something I really have to test once again, is there, here there is a bit of warping, and here there is a bit of warping. And this is something that I have, I think has to do with the heat plate or the bed itself on the printer, because no matter how I try to pre-calibrate it with the hand and then do ABL calibration, I always have build plate a bit warp in the center. So this is something that I have to play a bit in the future, or maybe even exchange that heated build plate for something else. But if you look at this print, it's really perfect in terms of bed adhesion. Second, when the print cools down, it's really perfect in popping it off. It really pops something similar to the glass, but it has better adhesion. And as you can see, those tiny prints are, they're sticking. You are able to remove them, but they give you some kind of resistance when trying to pull them off. So if you do a brim print, it can sometimes be very hard to remove it. Next thing what I tested is, of course, printing vertical. So it's 4 millimeter diameter and 100 millimeters tall print. Print itself is not perfect, as you can see there are some artifacts every half a centimeter or something like that. I have to look into it, why does it happen, and here I have some kind of artifact. But if I'm not mistaken, and you can check my previous video, this is the furthest I managed to print, from total of 99.7 millimeters or something like that in height that I was planning to print, it printed up to 95.7 millimeters. So it almost managed to print to the top, but unfortunately even this one didn't manage to keep it stuck to the plate. One of the reasons I think this is because I would probably have to reduce print speed from the original print speed for this test. I would probably have to reduce it down a much lower, and you always have the force on the top, the nozzle is touching the sprint when it's sprinting, and it gives some kind of resistance in terms of movement. Since this is very tall component, you do get some kind of wobbling, and that wobbling at the end just detaches this from the build plate. As far as the maintenance is concerned, I still haven't done much. I think that I only cleaned it with alcohol once or twice. I've seen that it's recommended that you use very fine sandpaper to grind if you have any kind of residue of your print, but so far I didn't have to do it. I managed to peel everything off, even if it took me a bit longer than normal. But this build plate really rocks. What I did also is I printed this for my kit. I just noticed there is some kind of artifact here. That's strange. I didn't notice that before. But as you can see, this is a really nice print. A Christmas tree. My daughter wants to have it in the room. Let me remove this first. How it's called? Patafix or something. This is the bottom side of the star. This is the bottom star of the Christmas tree. I do have here some issues with the print. Here didn't stick well, here didn't stick well, and here. And it goes something, it was something like this. So as you can see, most of them are once again in this central area of my printing. So there is something definitely wrong with my build plate, or however it's called, heat bed or whatever. And here the same, you have star, it was printed something like this, I think. Yeah, and once again, you have here in the center part that is warped. But this is it. I have received some comments in regard to your experiences with the original Ender 3 bed. And once again, I must stress out, it really did print great for me. It even printed great even without ABL. It prints even better, of course, with the ABL. But adding this textured metal steel sheet bed definitely improved on that. If you are looking for something, of course, you don't have to buy from this manufacturer. This is Chinese manufacturer. You can buy original ones, let's call it like that, from the manufacturers from the States. But I definitely would recommend this type of bed because it really keeps your print stuck. Unfortunately, this is it for this short episode of 3D Printing Bunker. I know it was a short one, but I really wanted to share with you my experience with this type of textured print bed. Thank you once again for watching. I hope I will be seeing you next time in 2 weeks. I did plan to release 2 other videos, but unfortunately some of the components for those videos are missing, and I will have to postpone that until further notice. I will think of something, probably show you my prints for the Christmas that I made for this year, for kids. If you still haven't subscribed, please subscribe and hit the bell button so you get notified. And until the next time, bye bye and have fun!